Guys, it's John with Greenfish Nation. I want to welcome you to the channel today. Today we're out here in Point at a little private honey hole. For two reasons, I just wanted to get out and shoot you guys a video. Wind's blowing about 25 miles an hour out of the south. Feels about like a blowtorch out here. It's about 105. Another reason is I got this new microphone system here. That way I don't have to be facing the camera all the time for you guys to hear me. So let me know what you think about this microphone. Today I think we're going to do a 5 top water challenge, and we'll choose those 5 baits. So you stay tuned to see the 5 baits in action here on Greenfish Nation. We're gonna choose 5 baits out of here, and we're gonna see how many fish we can catch on those 5 baits. What we're gonna do is we're gonna throw a bait, catch a fish, change it. Throw a bait, catch a fish, change it. So you gotta stay tuned and let's see how many fish we can catch on the top water. All right, guys, my first bait I'm gonna choose is the 4-inch Zara Spook. It's clear with a blue back. It's kind of in a sexy shad pattern. It's got a little yellow stripe on the side, little red eyes. So let's go see if we can't catch us a fish. All right, guys, we're down here. We got this walking top water tied on. We're going to give it a shot, so y'all stay tuned. May be kind of tough today. So pond's getting drier and drier. I'm down about 5 feet now. Usually catch one right in here. They may not be interested in anything on top today. We got about 1 inch of rain yesterday, but you can't tell it. Of course, this place doesn't get any runoff, Harley. All right, here we go. Spot number 2. We'll get out here where it's a little bit deeper. There's a big deep hole right out here. You guys can see where I'm pointing, but there's a big hole over there. About right on top of it, right there. Working this walking bait back and forth. Just seen a fish jump across the way over there, right next to the bank. Change our retrieve up a little bit and see if that helps anything. He was interested in it. I don't know if you guys could see that one blow up on it, but he ain't very big, but he was interested in it. Another one right down there ticking around on the top. A little bass, he's about 12 inches long, but that's lure number 1 out of the way. So you guys stay tuned, we're gonna try a popper next. All right, we're back with our next bait. This is a little popper. It's in a baby bass color. This is probably the first popper that I ever owned when I was a kid. It's always been good for me. It's about 2.5 inches long. We got a little feathers and a little marabou on the tail there. So get there and see what we can do. It's one of these poppers.
Music licensing reimagined.
right, guys, I'm just throwing this thing out there and just popping it a couple times and letting it sit for a second. If it was a real calm day, I'd let it sit till all the little waves was gone from around it. Today, it don't really matter. This is not an ideal topwater day. Very high, bright skies. Pretty windy. Pretty hot. There's one right there. He said, I'll take it today, hot or not, I'll take it. He's a little cuss, but he don't know it. All right, guys. Fish number two. Looks like we're gonna have a dink fest today. I can get him loose there. There we go. Fish number two on the old popper. Y'all stay tuned. We're gonna probably throw a tiny torpedo next. All right, guys, we're back with our next bait. This is another bait that I had for probably my first or second bait. This is a little heading, tiny torpedo. I can remember going and fishing over at a pond when I was a kid with my dad. A gentleman owned it by the name of Dr. Weiss. And man, it was loaded with bass, and we would tear them up on this. So you guys stay tuned for a little topwater prop action with the heading tiny torpedo. I'm just throwing this out there and just kind of ripping it along the top. It's a bright silver with a black back. Got a little red mouth on it. This kind of makes a little ripping noise. I don't know if you guys can hear that or not, or if you guys have ever fished one, but they're a pretty good little bait. They're kind of lightweight, but they'll throw good in the wind. Kind of mimics a little old shad or minnow or something, kind of skipping along the top. They got them in baby bass patterns. I got them in frog patterns, clear, just pretty much everything. Pink. There's one right there. He wanted it too, man. We must be on a nest of them right there. Ain't none of them very big, but they're a lot of fun to catch. Thought that might be the same one for a minute, but I don't believe it is. Hear people talking about all the time about they don't want to catch these little fish. I'll tell you right now, I'd rather catch a little fish than I would be in the best hospital of the country. I don't know about y'all. All right, guys, we're going to go get our next bait. I think we're going to throw a whopper plopper next, so y'all stay tuned. Hey, guys, we're back out here with bait number four out here at the honey hole on this little topwater fishing excursion. This is actually a whopper plopper brand bait. It's kind of in a brim pattern. You guys can see that. Let's see what we can do on this whopper plopper. This bait here casts a lot better than that last one. It's kind of like working a buzz bait that you can stop. It's got the little tail on it. Just goes around and around in a circle. Pause it. Just continuously pull it. Just kind of flips over in the water, the little tail does. You can fish it around any kind of cover, I guess, that you ain't afraid to get it hung up in. There's one. Try to take a lick at it right there. It must be coming over a hot spot right there. I'm just reeling it about 2 or 3 foot and then pausing it.
Music licensing reimagined.
That's probably a brim hitting at it. It looked like it. That orange belly. That ain't a brim. That first one had an orange belly on it, but that one didn't. That's a little better fish right there, guys. That and there weighed about two and a half pounds. He said, get that out of my neighborhood, man. Said, all this area down here belongs to me. Probably should have brought some pliers again, but I got it out. All right, guys, that's a little better fish there. He's probably, oh, I don't know, pound and a half, 2 pounds. That's a... four lures and four fish and less than 10 casts. So, all right, guys, we're back down here where that big fish was, trying to close out this five fish deal. So let's throw this old Dalton Twister out there. I think that was it. I think it's a pretty good fish. That ain't what hit it a while ago. That one a while ago was pulling drag. Maybe it's about to eat this one when I turn it loose. So y'all hang on, we're gonna try to get back out here and get that thing.
Music licensing reimagined.
I'd say it ain't too bad of a bait. Alright, guys, thank you for joining us today on this little five fish topwater challenge. But I got this old school Burroughs Bait Company Dalton Twist out and caught several fish on it here right at the end. I hope you enjoyed hanging out with us today. I know we enjoyed having you. Guys, if you hadn't subscribed, there's that little subscribe button over in the corner. It's got the little man in the boat on it. It says subscribe. Click that button. Tell somebody about us. Don't forget to leave us a comment. And up there at the top, there's that little notifications bell. Make sure you mash that so when you know we put out a new video. Until next time, I'm John with Greenfish Nation, and I want to wish every one of you tight lines.
Reimagined.